If you're a cat owner, you might have heard of Toxoplasma gondii, a protozoan that sometimes infects humans through contaminated feces in litter boxes. Although harmless to most, T. gondii can cause serious illness or death in immunocompromised people, and in fetuses of pregnant women. Now researchers reporting at ACS Nano have studied how the parasite glides so swiftly through mammalian tissues during an infection. According to the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, about 11% of people in the U.S. and up to 60% of people in some parts of the world have been infected with T. gondii. You can also get the parasite from contaminated food and water or blood transfusions. Pregnant women can pass it along to their fetuses, sometimes causing miscarriages or birth defects. Cats are the only organisms in which T. gondii reproduces sexually, and felines can expel large numbers of the parasite's oocytes in their feces. Once inside people or animals, the oocytes' envelopes get broken down, releasing parasites that enter cells of the small intestine. There, the invaders transition into what's called the tachyzoite stage, in which they move and multiply very quickly and spread throughout the body. They can then form cysts in muscle, eye, and brain tissues. Isabelle, Tardieux, and colleagues wanted to determine how these tiny tachyzoites glide so swiftly through tissues in a unique helical motion. Learning more about the parasite's movements could help scientists develop drugs to thwart their progress. Using 2D and 3D live imaging, the researchers examined the parasite's movements on fibers that mimicked the extracellular matrix, a dense network of proteins that surround cells and tissues. Tachyzoites squeeze through the meshwork by first pausing and forming a kink in the front part of their bodies. Then the cell bodies contracted and the parasite surged forward with a spring-like motion. The team used a technique to reveal where the parasite attached to the surface, shown here in red. As the tachyzoite produced a kink in its body, a single tight attachment formed that the parasite pulled on to propel itself forward. The researchers examined the forces associated with the kink, which coincided with the rear of the parasite's body slowly dragging forward, and then the sudden surge ahead. They also made a surface that the tachyzoite couldn't attach to. When the parasite tried to glide across the gray area on the left, it couldn't grab onto the surface. Instead, it just twirled on its back, showing that the front anchor is necessary for forward motion. Using super-resolution microscopy, the researchers could, for the first time, see the parasite's cytoskeleton, shown here in green, in both its compressed and relaxed positions. Putting all this information together, the researchers concluded that the parasite moves by forming and breaking specific attachments with the extracellular matrix, causing the buildup of forces in its cytoskeleton. When the front tip of the parasite releases its hold on the fibers, it springs forward with a super-fast helical glide.